Welcome to the first ever Tools of the Month. This is the Toolfinder edition, and today we're going to dive into lots of new tools, lots of tools that have been added to Toolfinder, and hopefully find a productivity tool that might interest you for fixing a basic solution or maybe a more complex solution. I'm very excited. I'm Francesco, by the way. If you're in the hunt for a productivity tool, jump over to Toolfinder and you'll find them all, including the ones in this video today. Today's feature is actually sponsored by Pipedrive. Now, if you're looking for a sales CRM tool that is perfect for sales people, then this is a really super option. Over 100,000 teams and clients use it, and we actually use it in the past. When I was working at a former company, we actually use it to manage book publishers and whether we could get them and track them through the sales process. And it's really powerful. There's lots of powerful functions in terms of tweaking the pipeline for managing a sale. And also, it's got some really awesome integrations for capturing every moment that happens with a sale. And it's really interesting in terms of how it's set up and really, really powerful. So you can find that linked below if you fancy checking out Pipedrive or you and your team need that. So let's dive into some of the options. And the first one is an app called Heptabase. And really interesting, Heptabase is an app that has come onto my radar multiple times. And it's been on my radar for some time because of its really expansive note-taking abilities in terms of the graph, in terms of a very visual view, because I believe that that's the future of productivity applications, very strangely. I feel like the interfaces will dramatically change in terms of complexity and focus much more on visual natures because our voice will be the command. That's my opinion, but as you can imagine, Heptabase is very much designed for that, and it's a really interesting experience. I'm in the process of doing a review on it in the moment, but as an application, it's a very visual note-taking experience, and it's sort of like Miro combined with Evernote if they had a baby. But a very interesting application that we've recently added to Toolfinder. Next up is one called Threads, and we're actually trialing Threads at Keep Productive. It is a really interesting application because what Threads does slightly differently is focus your conversation on Threads. You know, like Slack, it's a really incoming messages everywhere. And for teams, that can be quite overwhelming. Of course, you can start Threads on Slack, but this is a thread first thinking. So you can create a thread when you and your team are actually like wanting to get something solved or there's a problem, and actually then start the conversation around the thread, which is much more productive in my opinion. We actually use another app called Twist, but we're trialing Threads just to see what it's like. And there's some really interesting features like block level management, which means you can reply to comments that are in blocks inside of Threads, which means you can actually get deeper levels of conversation. And there's some great abilities with voice channels as well, which is similar to Slack huddles as well. And we're really digging a little bit deeper in our review, which is coming out later. But a very interesting application and definitely one that's on our radar for 2024. Next up is an AI one. It's called PDF AI. And we did a recent review on it, but basically imagine PDF AI, you can chat with your PDFs. And that sounds weird, doesn't it? But basically, imagine if you're in school or you are doing a report at work, or maybe even you've got legal questions or a document in front of you, then what you can basically do is upload the PDF. And from there, you can ask it questions using ChatGPT, which everyone knows already. But it really gives you that level of depth and you can dig a little bit deeper into what's actually part of the content and contextualize it to what's already out there. So you can really try and humanize a document by asking simple questions like, what does this mean? In layman's terms. I actually did that a couple months ago with just copy and paste in ChatGPT, but this really is an interesting app for just bypassing that. So an interesting one, very micro in terms of what the offerings is in the market, but a little bonus application that focuses on AI. Next up is chosen by Charlotte, who is our mindful tools expert. She picked, and I will definitely get her on to dive into the tools of the month next month for sure, but she picked Headspace as her tool of choice, and it's a meditation application, and she has been using it daily because she finds the experience really interesting in terms of being able to set a routine for her with meditating and having that daily routine and exercise. If you're interested in following Charlotte on YouTube, you can dive over to her own channel, which she will be diving into productivity tools that are focused on mindfulness. And you can find all of the more recent mindful tools that she's added over on Toolfinder. And finally, one that I did a really deep dive on, which was called an app called Paymo. Now, this is really designed for like freelancers or small teams, maybe even medium-sized teams as well, they're looking to associate their projects based on income. For example, if you bill your time or you set a retainer as a marketing agency or as a freelancer and you track your time associated to that billing, this basically does all stages of the progress. So you can manage a task that is associated to the invoice, that is associated to the client, which is really interesting. So it's sort of like a project management software designed more for those who bill with their time or those who bill and want to have that whole experience in one. The invoices are really cool in it, but largely it's a very nice time tracking experience. And I guess you could use it as a small team or maybe even just one person, but it really does have to be based around billing, which is different. But again, we've done a really in-depth review on Toolfinder on it, and I found it to be actually pretty impressive. Great project management abilities, great ways to weave in invoices, and actually found it to be one of the larger experiences that it was sort of like finding a little bit of a TARDIS. I went in and was expecting like a small box and I opened up and there was like loads of stuff in there. So again, a bit of a TARDIS experience. Those who don't know what TARDIS is, just Google it. I'm sure you'll find it. Anyway, folks, I hope you enjoyed Tools of the Month. Thank you very much to Pipedrive for sponsoring today's segment. You can find Pipedrive below. And if you're in the hunt for any productivity tools, you can jump over to Toolfinder and find everything there. And we'll make sure to link that up in the description. All right, folks, I'll see you soon. And here's some more videos that you might be interested in. Cheerio.